Bismillah walhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa lah amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. So today we're going to take a look at an ayah in Surah Al-Hijr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, لَهَا سَبَعَةُ أَبْوَابٍ لِكُلِّ بَابٍ مِّنْهُمْ جُزْءٌ مَقْسُومٌ. Allah says, it has seven gates, for every gate is of them a portion designated. This piqued my curiosity. What is it about this number seven? Why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the hellfire seven different gates? Now, when you look into this issue, you find that, subhanAllah, there are many, many different opinions as to why this is the case. I just want to share with you a few points that I thought were fascinating. One opinion from Al-Dhahhak, rahimahullah, he says that these are for the seven different categories of people, and he refers to the Muslims who have too many sins that they need to be purified. They can't go directly to paradise. They need to be purified first. That's number one. Then he says the gate for Christians, Jews, Sabians, the Majus, the polytheists, and then those who knew the truth, but instead of practicing it, they just pretended to believe and were actually faking it. And subhanAllah, this is the category I want to focus on, because it seems that when it comes to the lowest level, there seems to be a consistency in the Quran. And I find it so fascinating that when we think of ourselves and our predecessors, we realize that there are three major prophets. Those three major prophets being who? Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And even though all of these prophets were teaching Islam, it seems that Musa alayhi salam, his people turned into the Yahud. From Isa alayhi salam, they turned into the Nasara. And then we are the Muslims still maintaining the truth of Islam. Now, what is so fascinating is that when it comes to this lowest level, the hypocritical level, those who fake the religion, those who understand the religion, they turn their backs on it. It seems that there are three ayat that specify that these type of people, whether they're from amongst the people of Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, or from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, all three of them will be in the lowest part. So let's give some examples. When it comes to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we find Allah says what? إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. That indeed the hypocrites will be in the lowest depths of the fire. When it comes to Musa alayhi salam, we find that the people of Fir'aun, they witnessed these miracles, and despite seeing and witnessing these miracles, they rejected the truth. Allah tells them what? وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ أُدْخِلُوا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ أَشَدَّ الْعَذَابِ. That Allah says, and the day, the hour appears, it will be said to them, make the people of Fir'aun enter into the worst of punishments. When it comes to the disciples of Isa alayhi salam, we find that subhanAllah, they asked him to send down a ma'idah, a table spread full of food. And so Allah Ta'ala granted them what they requested. After Isa alayhi salam made the dua, Allah Ta'ala gave them this ma'idah, and then Allah said something very important. قَالَ اللَّهُ إِنِّي مُنَزِّلُهَا عَلَيْكُمْ فَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بَعْدُ مِنْكُمْ فَإِنِّي أُعَذِّبُهُ عَذَابًا لَا أُعَذِّبُهُ أَحَدًا مِنَ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah says, indeed, I will send it down to you, but whoever disbelieves afterwards from among you, then indeed I will punish him with a punishment by which I have not punished anyone among the worlds. So subhanAllah, isn't it amazing that when it comes to the worst of punishments, it seems to be consistent that anybody who is given the most proof, anybody who understands the truth by witnessing miracles, being amongst the believers, by claiming Islam, and then turning their back after all the evidence, after all the acceptance and understanding has been established, if you turn your back then subhanAllah, it doesn't matter if you're from the people of Musa alayhi salam, of Isa alayhi salam, or in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, you're going to get the worst of punishments. This is something that I find amazing, the consistency within it. Furthermore, there's another interesting observation. Like I said, there are many different interpretations as to why seven. But I found one interpretation really fascinating. One explanation is that there are seven sources when it comes to sins. They are the eyes, the ears, the tongue, regarding what you speak, the stomach, what you consume, the private parts, and the hands, what you do, and your feet, where you go. These seven represent what? Your deeds, how you behave in this life, what you say, what you consume in terms of information, what you listen to and what you watch. SubhanAllah, it seems that these seven cover the bases. And so subhanAllah, this is like a warning telling us what? That there are seven gates of hellfire. Be very wary of the way shaitan enters into your life. Be very wary of your deeds, what you look at, what you listen to, what you say. Be very wary of how you use your private parts. Be very wary of what you consume and eat. Be very cautious when it comes to your work and what you do, and be very cautious what you do with your feet, where you go. SubhanAllah, I find this to be a very powerful warning. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from these seven sources of sins. May Allah ta'ala always make us conscious of these seven sources where sins can approach us. So no matter where you are on these seven continents of the earth, or whether you're traveling through the seven seas of this planet, and it doesn't matter when you are in terms of the 7 days of the week, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who can rise up through the seven heavens, up into paradise, and may Allah ta'ala make us of those who die upon seven words. What are they? La ilaha illa Allah Muhammadun Rasulullah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.